Hi, this is Jeremy Schuback of the Photoshop Expert Series. This is episode 12. How to remove anything from an image. Part 1. So in this part, we are going to be talking about automating it. I could get into the stamp tool, but why bother? So first thing you always do when correcting anything is you create a new layer, because you never want to make adjustments on the layer itself. Just in case a mistake is done, you can always go back. This guy looks pretty awesome, pretty cool. Why did I just say that? This guy looks fine, except there's a pimple right here. So I could use the stamp tool to fix it. We're just going to use the spot healing brush. I'm going to click it, and it is going to be fixed. Or I could go in and I could use the patch tool. So I just I don't select around the area that I want it to look like, because if I do that, notice I need to be on the layer of in order to do this. I can't do it on an extra layer, which kind of hurts me. If I do it like that, all it will do is will duplicate the pimple, which is exactly the opposite of what I want. So I'm going to deselect this. We select around the area that we want fixing. So I'm going to just do that. Could not use the patch tool because the selected area is empty. Make sure you're on the right layer. Whenever there's a problem, always just make sure you're on the right layer. Select to an area that's generally the same. It will fade it in. Looks pretty good to me. However, let's be honest. This was an absurdly easy example. So, okay, just a couple more about the automated tools before I move on. Don't worry about that. Red eye tool, it removes red eyes. You select over a red eye, and it will get rid of red eyes. So that is all hunky-dory. I'm not going to close out of this image. I'm going to go back to it in a little bit. All right, so let's go to my next image. Now, the problem with using the automated tools is they're automated, so they can't always do the best of jobs. So if I were to try to use the spot healing brush right here, I'm just going to rub across it and hope for the best. And obviously what I'm trying to do, not so obvious, but what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to remove the remote control. It does a decent job, but you can really see it's not working exactly how I want. So I'm going to not use the spot healing brush, and I could try going in further and be like, oh, maybe if I press here, it will fade it in further and not cause further problems. I don't know about that. I'm going to step back, and I'm going to go into my patch tool, and I'm going to do exactly what I did with the pimple. Again, most of the time you can't use these tools in order to accomplish this, but hey, this is a rare exception where it's probably rather possible. So I'm going to deselect, and that's actually looking pretty good. This is actually a great example where the patch tool works just fine and is the preferable method to use. But let's say you have an image that's a little bit harder, and I really mean just a tiny, insy little bit harder. So let's say you have an image like this one. Now, you could try using the patch tool. I think we've established that trying to use here. I'm going to actually set a selection with the lasso tool first, and one thing that I want you to notice is I'm making sure to maintain this edge. So I've maintained that edge right there. Then I go into the patch tool. Then I kind of move up for what I want to do with it. And I'm going to deselect. And what I want you to notice is in its efforts to fade this in, we get a problem. We don't get this nice solid edge. All right, so let's say that I also want to try the spot healing brush just to humor you, just in case you're like, hey, maybe this will work. No, it won't. And then the other thing I could actually try is the content aware fill. Okay, that didn't work at all. But we're not going to get into that right now. I'm going to use the content aware fill when it does work, because I want you to love that tool, because that is actually an automation tool that has some use in the world. As opposed to these, which I guess red eye removal is good, but there's simpler tools than Photoshop to remove red eye. We're going to use the stamp tool. I'm sure you've used the stamp tool before. Process for using a stamp tool. Put it on a new layer, set the stamp tool to current and below, make sure that it's not on current or you won't be able to do anything, because it'll only be trying to copy and paste from the layer you're on, which is an empty layer. If you want, you can rename that layer, although I rarely rename layers. One thing I like to do is that I go into Photoshop Preferences, blue cursors, and then I like to show the crosshairs in the middle of the brush tip, and that'll be immediately obvious why. So you'll notice that in the middle of my brush hair, I have this cross tip that tells me exactly where the middle is. Now when I hit Alt and I paste, I can make sure that the edge is in exactly the right place, because I made sure that the edge was in the middle when I did it here. So now when I paste it, so I just got to let go of Alt and paste it in, that edge is continuous, because I made sure to keep the edge consistent. So I'm just going to press Alt and then click and then make sure that that edge is still right in the center. And, you know, then we'll get a pretty good selection. All right, this zoom-in thing is kind of annoying me. All right, so then we'll get a pretty good selection. Now, remember, what you're trying to avoid in all cases with this is you don't want this to happen. And if you've used the stamp tool before, you've probably run into cases of this happening or even worse, something like this happening. We do not want that to happen. And the way to avoid it is to always look at the edges. So I'm going to make sure the center's on the edge when I Alt-click, or when I sample, that's the technical name for this. And then when I go back here, I can, you know, do this. All right, now I told you to do it on a layer above, and I'm just going to go. If I really wanted, I could probably use one of the automated tools for an easy section like this, but it's not hard for me to go in and just fix all this. You'll notice that I'm actually sampling between almost every single click. We're going to get rid of that red dot in the middle because it's kind of hard to see what's happening with it there. That was just there so you could see whenever I mouse clicked. But if I know anything about this audio, you'll actually hear every time I click the mouse, and it's pretty obvious. All right, so I can go in, I can increase this, and you know what? That looks pretty darn good. I would have not known a remote control was there a mere, you know, minute ago, and quicker if I hadn't been talking to you this entire time.